So you've determined that you're going to need a web sling for your project, but you're not sure which one to choose. In today's video, we're going to talk about how you can choose the right web sling for your application. If you like this type of content, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel for more helpful videos on rigging products and projects. When it comes to choosing the right sling for your application, the first and most important thing that you want to consider is going to be the working load limit of the sling and how it relates to the loads that you're going to be lifting. The working load limit of the sling is going to be dependent upon the sling's construction, its size, and also how you configure it during the lift. Slings are constructed of what are called plies, and you can kind of think of plies as layers of polyester webbing. The more plies that a sling has, the stronger and more rigid that it's going to be. For example, this is a one-ply sling, and you can see that it doesn't maintain its shape very well. It can kind of maneuver around a little bit in your hands, versus a two-ply sling, which is going to be a lot thicker, and it's also going to maintain its shape a lot better. The sling's width is also going to affect its working load limit. The wider the sling, the stronger that it's going to be, but also the more support that it's going to give the object that you're lifting. Let's take these two slings for example. They're both one ply slings, but this is a 2-inch wide sling and this is a 3-inch wide sling. Now the difference between the two is that the 3-inch wide sling is going to hold 1600 pounds more than the 2-inch sling. The length of the sling is not going to affect the sling's strength, regardless of how long or short that it is, but you do want to make sure that you choose a sling that is going to have a length that's suitable for your application, and also take into consideration that configuring the sling in different ways might potentially reduce the working load limit. Click the link below to learn more about lifting angles and load capacity reduction factors on our website. If you find yourself configuring your slings in a way where the eyes of the sling are taking the majority of the load, like say in a basket hitch, you might want to consider getting reinforced eyes, since the eye is going to be protected better against abrasion. How you configure a sling during a lift can impact the sling's working load limit, and this is something that you're going to want to always consider every time you use a sling. If you look at this sling here in particular, you'll see that there's a certification tag that is sewn into the sling, and this is going to be the same for any sling that you get from erigging.com. On the tag, you'll find how different configurations of the sling are going to affect its working load limit, and this is something that's very important to keep in mind, especially if you have a lot of slings lying around that you're using for different applications. If you ever find yourself losing this tag, you don't want to use the sling because the working load limit of the sling is going to be unknown for different configurations. Thanks for hanging out with us today, guys. Hopefully you learned a little something about web slings, and for our next video, we're going to be heading down to the warehouse where we're going to show you three different ways to configure web slings whenever you're lifting an object. So make sure that you subscribe to our channel so you don't miss it. I'm Tyler with eRigging. Thanks for watching.